SpaceX is once again on track to apply for a license for the launch of Starship Flight 3, after the latest explosion of Ship 25 and Booster. However, there is a positive development this time around. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service conducted an assessment of the Boca Chica, Texas area after the launch, which took place from SpaceX's Starbase launch facility in South Texas, on November 18. The flight achieved significantly more milestones than the first, including keeping the area much cleaner. Although some small pieces of debris were observed, they are easily removable. A representative for the FWS stated that the main impact noticed by staff was to the tidal flats, which occurred when the public entered the area for several hours to watch the launch. Foot traffic, chairs, and off-leash dogs can impact this sensitive habitat. The Wildlife Agency's assessment is significant for SpaceX, which received criticism over the amount of debris it spread on nearby land during the first Starship launch back in April. The Federal Aviation Administration oversaw a mishap investigation into the last launch and required a number of site changes before granting approval for the latest flight. SpaceX's Starbase launch facility is located next to a wildlife refuge that includes tidal flats. The FWS said that it will work with SpaceX to educate the public on preserving the flats, as well as potentially coming up with alternative viewing locations for the public to watch the next launch. After Starship's first test flight spread chunks of debris and concrete over hundreds of acres of nearby landscape, this is a positive sign for SpaceX. SpaceX has made some modifications to the Starship's launch mount by adding massive steel plates underneath it. This is to help absorb and mitigate the intense forces and heat created by the Raptor engines during takeoff. The water deluge system, which gushes large amounts of water upward, is also designed to help with this. The system worked well during the second test flight, and CEO Elon Musk was pleased with the launchpad's condition, and the fact that the deluge system required no refurbishment ahead of the next launch attempt. Musk has also stated that the Super Heavy booster and Starship spacecraft will likely be ready for a third test flight in 3 to 4 weeks. There are currently 4 Starship spacecraft and at least 2 Super Heavy booster in final production. However, it's unclear how long it will take for SpaceX engineers to review the data gathered during Saturday's flight and implement any necessary changes. It's also uncertain whether SpaceX will have the necessary regulatory approvals to launch another test flight in just a few weeks. The FAA has indicated its intentions to open a standard mishap investigation into Saturday's test flight. Once the investigation is closed, the federal agency will likely need to complete a safety review of SpaceX's plans for a third launch before issuing another permit. The timeline for the approval process remains uncertain, and we are all hoping for a swift resolution. The top 2 lawmakers on the U.S. Senate Space and Science Subcommittee are urging federal regulators to expedite the approval of commercial space launches. They argue that the current pace could jeopardize the United States' position in the new space race. In a letter to the head of the Federal Aviation Administration Commercial Space Flight Office, Senators Kieran Sinha and Eric Schmidt implored FAA Associate Administrator Kelvin Coleman to eliminate red tape and reduce delays in processing launch and reentry licenses. As the number of launches from U.S. commercial space flight companies increases and China's state-backed space industry continues to grow, it is crucial that the FAA and other federal agencies adapt to keep pace with American innovation and adversarial threats in space. The FAA's Office of Commercial Space Transportation is responsible for upholding public safety while greenlighting a growing number of commercial space launches. The FAA has already licensed 104 launches this year, compared to 26 launches in 2019. Meeting industry demand is a priority for several reasons, including national security and civil exploration needs. The FAA is working diligently to attract, hire, and retain additional staff. The senators named NASA's commercial partners involved in the agency's flagship human space flight program and urged Coleman to fast-track high-priority missions, such as returning Americans to the moon. SpaceX, led by Elon Musk, is responsible for the development of the HLS variant of the Starship, which will be used as a lunar lander to transport astronauts to the surface of the Moon for the first time since the Apollo program. Despite facing a lengthy environmental review by the FWS and a safety review by the FAA, after the company's first test flight of its massive moon rocket exploded about 4 minutes after lifting off in April. SpaceX was given the green light to proceed last week. The company completed a partially successful second test flight on Saturday, but there are still many milestones left to hit before a moon landing can be achieved. Musk previously acknowledged in 2020 that he hopes SpaceX will launch hundreds of missions with satellites before attempting a flight with crew. SpaceX must also build and test the versions of Starship that will serve as refueling tankers, and a lander must be outfitted with life support equipment. NASA will require Starship to make an uncrewed test landing on the moon before allowing its astronauts on board. Despite facing criticism for its failed test flights, SpaceX's development process embraces fiery mishaps in the early stages of designing a rocket in order to learn how to build a better rocket faster than if the company solely relied on ground tests. NASA will pay SpaceX about $4 billion for 2 lunar landings, and the company has already invested more than $3 billion in developing its South Texas launch facility and the Starship Super Heavy launch system since 2014. According to a court filing by the FAA on May 19, NASA astronaut Christina Hammock spoke at a media gathering in Washington on May 18, 2023. She was joined by NASA astronauts Victor Glover and Reid Wiseman, as well as Canadian Space Agency astronaut Jeremy Hansen. Wiseman, Glover, Hammock, Koch, and Hansen are expected to embark on a mission around the moon called Artemis II in 2024. To put things into perspective, the development of NASA's Space Launch System, rocket and Orion spacecraft for the Artemis program, has cost over $44 billion since 2006, as per data from the nonprofit Planetary Society. Last year, the SLS rocket had its first flight test. Under NASA's current plans, the SLS and Orion would transport astronauts from Earth to lunar orbit, while SpaceX's Starship would complete the final leg of the journey, ferrying them from the Orion spacecraft to the moon's surface. However, it's worth noting that SpaceX follows a different development approach compared to NASA. While NASA invests years in careful design and rigorous ground testing to ensure success on the first flight, SpaceX is willing to put early prototypes in the air, even if there's a chance they may explode. This approach allows them to gather valuable information for future testing. It's a different paradigm, as mentioned by an expert named Hale. When working with taxpayers' dollars, the government understandably prioritizes caution and success. On the other hand, SpaceX, being a private company, has a different methodology. Both approaches have the potential for success, but SpaceX's approach certainly has its exciting moments. In conclusion, it is important for SpaceX to have as many Starship launch windows as possible to continue their innovative work in support of the government's goals. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you. So thank you very much, and we hope to see you again next time.